Yo, what up, though? The Minnesota Vikings, they're back at the crib. They back in Minnesota this weekend against the 5-4 New Orleans Saints, man. The Saints, the 1-2 in a row. Last week game, I wasn't impressed. I'm not going to lie to y'all. They barely beat the Chicago Bears, man. And that's why I feel like the Minnesota Vikings will come out with this W. And I'm going to tell y'all why. The New Orleans Saints offense isn't that good right now, even with Derek Carr. I thought Carr was going to play way better in New Orleans than how he is playing, man. Derek Carr isn't looking good over there, man. The wide receiver group over there is okay. Like, I feel like the Minnesota Vikings will keep their wide receivers in check. You just got to watch out for that boy Chris Ale, whatever that wide receiver's name is. He a fast one. But I got faith in Brian Flores. And Derek Carr isn't that good. So I feel like the Minnesota Vikings will blitz Derek Carr. And Derek Carr will give us the football at least twice if the Minnesota Vikings can get those interceptions, man. And the offense, the Minnesota Vikings offense, man, Dobbs will have a whole week of preparation. Dobbs will be playing with a whole group of different wide receivers than what the Minnesota Vikings used to, man, this year. JJ won't play. KJ is out. Brandon Powell, Jai, Thrisha Jackson, Keneal Harry will have to step up for the Minnesota Vikings, man. TJ Hockenson should play this weekend, so that's a big up for the Minnesota Vikings. Christian Darrisaw probably won't play, but he ain't played last week, and the Minnesota Vikings offensive line did good against the Atlanta Falcons, and the Falcons defense is better than the Saints defense. The Saints defense give up an average 112 yards on the ground. That's why the Minnesota Vikings need to try and establish a run game this weekend against New Orleans Saints. And I'm not talking about a run game with Dobbs. I'm talking about with the running backs, man. I would like to see Ty Chandler get more carries this weekend against the New Orleans Saints, man. I want the Minnesota Vikings to rush for an average 130 yards against the New Orleans Saints, man. I don't care. Honestly, I don't care where it's coming from, man. If Dobbs want to break out and have 100 yards on the ground, I'm okay with that at this point. Because the Minnesota Viking run game have to get better, man. Madison got to get better as running the football. That's why I want to see Ty Chandler get more carries, man. And I feel like Brandon Powell and TJ will have a big game against the New Orleans Saints defense, man. Brandon Powell, I won't be surprised if he gets some wide receiver sweeps against the New Orleans Saints defense. Something to help and boost this running game that the Minnesota Vikings needs to bring alive if they won't make a run in the playoff this year, man, because you can't be one-dimensional in the playoffs or going out for the rest of the year, man. And Dobbs got a turn down on the turnovers, man. I know last week he lost two fumbles, but he really had three. I would like to see Dobbs with no turnovers this weekend against the New Orleans Saints, man. And the Minnesota Vikings will win this game regardless if they can turn down on the turnover, because we cannot turn the ball over two or three times and think we're going to beat the New Orleans Saints, because I don't think that's going to happen if we do that. Because the Saints do got that one player who do it all in Hill. They might put Hill at quarterback, wide receivers, running back, anything. Because Hill can run the football, and the Minnesota Vikings got to prepare for Hill, because that's all the New Orleans Saints got, honestly. That's why I feel like the Minnesota Vikings will win this game, man. Our defense is playing good this year. And I don't think Derek Carr is a quarterback I got to worry about against the Minnesota Vikings defense. I'm going to be for real with y'all. But I want to see more out of the offense, man. And I think the offense will play way much better this week against New Orleans Saints, man. Dobbs will get to build some chemistry with the wide receivers. He gets to learn the cadence that the Minnesota Vikings use. He gets to learn more plays with the Minnesota Vikings compared to last week. That's another reason why I think the Minnesota Vikings will beat the Saints. And the Minnesota Vikings right now, with all the injuries we do have, I feel like we are just a better team than the New Orleans Saints. So I think the Minnesota Vikings will win this game again, 31-17, man. The Minnesota Vikings scored 31 again. No, I'm going to go for 34. We will score 34 points against the New Orleans Saints, man, compared to their 17. And the Minnesota Vikings will move to 6-4, man. But y'all let me know in the comment section below. How do you feel about the New Orleans Saints and the Minnesota Vikings matchup, man? And this game right here, got big playoff implication. They both are 5-4. They both are in the NFC. And at the end of the season, it might come down to tiebreakers. And the Minnesota Vikings win this game against another NFC opponent, that's good for us down the line. So that's another reason why the Minnesota Vikings need to win this football game. And plus, we only 2 games behind Detroit Lions for the NFC North. So the North still is in our reach, but we got to go out and win these games starting on Sunday, man. I got the Minnesota Vikings beating the New Orleans Saints, man. Let me know in the comment section below. Do you feel like the Minnesota Vikings will beat the New Orleans Saints? And do you think Dobbs will continue to play good for the Minnesota Vikings? Or is this the week Dobbs cool off? And people say, well, you know he a backup. You know people can't wait to say that, man. I think Dobbs put that shit on hold, man. I think Dobbs will ball out against New Orleans Saints, man. He will throw for 2 passing touchdowns, 1 rushing touchdown, and he will have 0 turnovers, man. And we will get another rushing touchdown on the ground with one of our running backs. I think Ty Chandler will get in the end zone, man. But y'all let me know in the comment section below. How do y'all feel about the Vikings and the New Orleans Saints?